What's up, peeps? Today I'm going to share with you my workflow with the Insta360 1x2 using the Insta360 app. One of the main reasons why I really like the Insta360 is the app and the ease of the workflow. This is not sponsored, this is just me sharing my experience. So one of the main problems I used to always have was I would go out on an adventure, I would shoot footage, and then it would sit around so long because I couldn't do anything with it. So I'm gonna share with you my workflow and how it makes my life a lot easier. Editing and posting. And I'll show you how I do that. So once the footage is on here, you need to transfer it to a device. I use my iPhone. This will also work on Android. I'm using an iPhone. So the first thing I do, turn on the Insta360 app. I go into album, then turn on the camera. A lot of times I'll just have it plugged into the USB. And then top corner, there's a camera. Hit that and you see the 1X listed as a device. And there's actually two different ways that you can download the footage. I'm gonna show this way and then I'll show a different way. I now have the phone connected to the camera. Up here, top right, this little box with a check. Click on that, and then I select the videos or pictures that I want to download to the device. Now at the bottom, you'll see a circle with an arrow. It's the second one over from the left. That is the download. So what that does is transfer the video from or pictures from the device to your phone. Takes a little while. Be patient. You can do this in the field. You can do it right after you shoot. It's real nice and easy. The second way, which is kind of like the new way, you have one of these, the quick card reader adapter. You can take the card out of the 1X2, place it into this, slides right in there. This will also work on USB-C and Lightning, so you have both those adapters. There's no extra pieces you have to put on there. This plugs right into my phone. This is so easy. When you plug it into the phone, you will see it automatically recognizes the quick reader, shows you everything that's on that card, and I don't have to actually download it to my phone. I can work with the files right off the memory card. Time saver right there. So there's no transferring. I'm able to access it right here, real time. So here's a rundown of the software. At the top, shows you what device you're looking at. I'm looking at the quick reader. You can flip it to local. And then you have all, which shows a combination of both. So I'm going to read off the quick reader. If you download the files, you would use local. Underneath that, this first box shows all the files. That shows photos. That one will show your videos. And then you can mark certain ones as favorites. So if I go through and I look at the different videos, say I like that one. I can go up to the top here and then click the star, and now if I go here, that will show up as a favorite. So that's a quick editing tip right there to save time. So I'll go into video, and as soon as I shoot something, I will go through, look at the footage and see which ones I like, and I'll mark them as favorites. Then that way they will show up as favorites, making my job a lot easier and faster. Next, it will show grouping by dates, which is really helpful. So as you can see, there's different dates here for the different events. Okay, so now let's go into an event. Let's go into some footage and take a look at it. This is Volcano Bay in Orlando. I was down there for a day. So one of the big benefits of the software is it's not only 360 where I can pan it around and pick the shot that I want. I can also reformat. Rather than just the 16:9 the long way for like Instagram or any other social media that people might watch on their phone, I can change the format to the widescreen, which would be viewed on a TV, a tablet, and that's using the second button here with the little box. These are your different formats that you can just click right into. Now let's go over to scissors. I'll show you the scissors here. So the scissors is for the trim. So you got two different versions of trim. You can trim the whole file, or you can do what's called a jump cut. You click on the one that says jump cut. And what jump cut allows you to do is only use certain segments of the video. and the little scissors pop up. So I click on the scissors, it's yellow letting me know now whatever I show would be kept. And then if I click on the scissors again, it's gonna skip whatever's in there. And then I can click on the scissors again and say, I want this part now and to there and then skip. Or you can click on it and then just play it regular. And when you get to a part you wanna stop. I use this a lot. Let's say I'm doing a driving and there's a part where I get to a stoplight. I don't wanna have it continue to show me stopped at a stoplight, so I'll just cut that part out. That's where the jump cut really comes in handy. This is non-destructive editing also, so if I change my mind, I can pull back into a section that I am keeping, I can change the length of it, or I can just hit cancel and get rid of it. It's all non-destructive, which allows me to do the edits. Say I wanna do one, a quick one for Instagram Reels, do the edit, I line it up, I trim it, and then I say, I'm gonna use that same footage for a YouTube video. I can change the format, even change what I'm looking at and completely trim it a different way. I don't use the multi-view. Multi-view just, it will allow you to see two different views. So if you're doing a driving thing and different things, so it's not really part of my flow. Stat shows you speed. I don't use it. Auto frame, I don't use that. Snapshot takes a screenshot. So if I want to get a picture of the volcano right there, I can hit the snapshot and it takes a picture. Face filter, I don't use that. Music, I'm not using that. Speed comes in handy if you want to speed up. You get your different choices here. One of the things in the software, it has a motion blur. So it doesn't look choppy, it doesn't look digital. It makes it kind of smooth with the fast forward. I've used that a couple times rather than do it in the editing software just to give it a nice smooth speed. You can't speed ramp filters. I don't use those. Those are just like your typical adjustment. That's your exposure, your color temperature, color brightness. Sometimes I use it. Majority of the time I don't. I wait until I get into my editing software. Mark is, if you're playing through the video and there's a part that you want to just mark, you hit that and it leaves a little dot on the timeline. So when you go back, scrubbing back through the timeline, you can say, oh, that's the part where something so forth and something happened. Next one is reset edits. That takes away all your edits that you put in there and brings you right back to zero. Delete will delete it off of the card or your device, whatever you're reading it from. And then next is download. If I press the download button will take it from the card and put it onto the device, onto the phone. Snap edit. And what Snap Edit is even faster way to edit. Line up your phone, whatever shot you want to use. Your format's right down here in the corner. So if you want to do Instagram Reels, 9x16, there's a slider on the side to zoom in, magnify, pull out, tiny planet. You can do it all by that. And then as I move my phone around, it will pan the picture, or I can use my finger to pan it also. Once I have where I want to start, you tap on the record button and it does it real time. And then it saves it as a clip. And it's a fast way to edit. And puts it over to the side so you can then just export it straight to your camera roll. So one of the ways I typically will edit a video, go up to export, and typically when you go into export, it's gonna be in auto. I always suggest going to custom. Turn your resolution all the way up, as far as it'll go. Turn your frame rate up, as far as it'll go. Bit rate is kinda like the quality. I suggest at least 100 for the bit rate. Color plus, remove grain. I don't use them majority of the time. Then you just hit export. You wanna make sure you leave this open. It's gonna go through rendering the video. The video is saved. You don't need to do anything else. It's automatically put into your photo album. So you can hit the X. So the video is off the device. It's in the phone. Now what do I use to edit? I use Lumafusion to edit my videos with. This is a real easy software. I'm gonna show how to use Lumafusion in the next part.